It's time now for the Old Time Gospel Hour with Jerry Falwell, pastor of the Thomas Road Baptist Church in Lynchburg, Virginia. We are not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation.
Good morning, and I welcome
you. I am righteous and to praise Him.
Do you know why Jim Baker's on television, you modernist preachers?
For all that
it's your fault I'm on TV.
Listen, don't you dare leave your television set.
We were actively engaged in planning to televise the second coming of Jesus.
If your church won't praise God, then we got to do it on television. The cameras are praising the Lord. The satellites are praising the Lord. The transmitters are praising the Lord. Come on, choir, sing it. Come on, people, worship the Lord.
More than 400 stations, televised services from the Cathedral of Tomorrow, carry the gospel of Jesus Christ into millions of homes throughout all of North America and around the world. In conjunction with the television aspect of the ministry, Rex Humbard and the Cathedral Singers make personal appearances in more than 60 cities, giving people like yourself an opportunity to meet their television pastor in person.
There's a woman here with cancer of the womb, and I don't think it's been diagnosed. You didn't know what it was. It's been excessive bleeding, and God has healed that right now tonight. It's healed. Thank you, Lord.
Well, thank you, Jesus.
Standing in the office of the prophet of God, I execute judgment on you, COVID-19.
Oh,
I execute judgment on you, Satan, you destroyer, you killer, you get out, you break your power, you get off this nation.
NBC Nightly News with Tom Brokaw.
Good evening. This Christmas week begins with a series of disasters. There was a...
Here's a story of a lovely lady who was bringing up three very lovely girls. All of them had hair of gold, like their mother, the youngest one in curls.
It's the story of a man named Brady.
Don't be afraid. I am with you every day till the end of time.
I'd give it 1982, but date setting is dangerous. I'd say within the next couple of years, we're going to see a war there. The next major war to be fought in the world is going to be right here.
Here?
Here.
Why?
Because the Bible says so. And Russia, the Bible says, is going to invade.
This is the emergency broadcast system. We are under attack by conventional forces of the Russian army. It is believed the lead waves were disguised as commercial charter flights. Communications have broken down with other parts of the country. Large areas of the Midwest may have been overrun.
Association of Evangelicals community from coast to coast in our great land
deeply appreciates and values his love for the truth of the Bible and his commitment to its great moral values. Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, Ronald Reagan.
Thank you. Thank you very much. A number of years ago, I heard a young father, a very prominent young man in the entertainment world, addressing a tremendous gathering in California. It was during the time of the Cold War, and communism and our own way of life were very much on people's minds, and he was speaking to that subject. And suddenly, though, I heard him saying, "I love my little girls more than anything," and I said to myself, "Oh no, don't, you can't, don't say that." But I had underestimated him. He went on, "I would rather see my little girls die now, still believing in God, than have them grow up under communism and one day die no longer believing in God."
Not bad for a bunch of kids, huh? I'm gonna be real proud.
The power of his wrath has come.
Now, if I'm hearing you right, things are starting to happen.
All we know is for sure is that the U.S. is going to stand against Russia and that Russia's going down. We don't know if it'll be nuclear. It could be. It doesn't have to be.
The policy of mutual assured destruction, which bears the appropriate acronym MAD, has paralyzed United States strategic thought for two decades. It is time for a bold new stroke in strategic planning.
It is the Cathedral of Tomorrow, home of the Rex Humbard World Outreach Ministry. This is a ministry with a single goal, and that is to follow Christ's great commission to go into all the world and preach the gospel.
Here, an artist's projection of the president's vision.
The satellites are praising the Lord. The transmitters are praising the Lord. Come on, choir, sing it. Come on, people, worship the Lord.
U.S. spy satellites would watch the world below, detect Soviet missiles blasting off, compute the position and speed of each missile, alert battle stations in space on Earth.
Red alert, red alert.
If the world is going to come to a catastrophic end anyway, what is to prevent me from pushing the button?
Nuke them. Get them before they get you. Another quality home game from Butler Brothers.
And you can just see the tempers flaring in our nation saying, let's go over there and show those fellows a lesson. It's almost as if something is goading somebody there to bring us against them. Well, when we do that, and we certainly have a right to, then...
The first response. Space-based kinetic energy weapons fire high-speed projectiles from hypervelocity guns, intercepting enemy missiles as they are boosted through the atmosphere.
Declassified material. It's a briefing on why we oppose an immediate nuclear freeze. I'd like for you to have this booklet.
But sharing a single idea, all governments must stop the madness of nuclear armament. The building of weapons so fast, so accurate, and so devastating that they invite a nuclear first strike.
A warning may come quite unexpectedly.
Pat Robertson takes an in-depth look at earth-shaking biblical prophecies being fulfilled right now. Startling events foreshadowing the end of the world as we know it.
Vladimir Khrushchev had already sent an urgent directive to KGB agents across the world.
The threat of an outbreak of nuclear war is reaching an extremely dangerous point. A surprise nuclear attack on the USSR has acquired even greater urgency and immediacy.
And that Russia's going down. We don't know if it'll be nuclear. It could be. It doesn't have to be. It could be. But there could be some big boom boom all around going on. when this thing starts.
If attack is imminent, you will hear the attack sound like this.
On the night of the 31st of August, 1983, Soviet air defenses in the Far East picked up an unknown aircraft heading towards a sensitive naval base.
The trespassing plane was already at southern Kamchatka, and as it came out over the Sea of Ochotsk, there appeared above it an interesting satellite. And then the plane sent a telegram to the satellite.
U.S. spy satellites would watch the world below.
The Soviet military were convinced that this was a U.S. spy plane probing their airspace. In 1983, American pilots regularly flew this kind of reconnaissance mission. They would gather as much intelligence as they dared before returning to international airspace.
Radio Free America started regular broadcasts at 12:23 while sailing back and forth along the coast between Cape May and Avalon.
It's 11:59 at Radio Free America, and this is Uncle Sam with music and the truth until dawn.
It was a literal time that this was going to happen. In fact, at CBN, we were actively engaged in planning to televise the second coming of Jesus.
And that's the ministry of Old Time Gospel Hour, reaching people with a saving gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. In a few moments, I'll be speaking on the subject, the end of the world. How near is it?
Well, I'd give it 1982, but date setting is dangerous. I'd say within the next couple of years, we're going to see a war there, the next major war.
In November that year, high-ranking NATO officers descended into a nuclear vault in Belgium.
Things are starting to happen. All we know is for sure is that the U.S. is going to stand against Russia and that Russia's going down.
America was about to attack. And at this precise moment, NATO began an exercise that rehearsed Armageddon.
Shall we play a game?
Love to. Let's play. Global thermonuclear war.
Fine.
Out in the forests of West Germany, signalers would send messages according to a tightly controlled script. These messages were then picked up in the NATO command bunker and passed on to the players of the game. The story was always the same. It began with a diplomatic incident, quickly escalated into a full-scale Soviet invasion of Europe, and on the last day of the exercise, it would end in an imaginary nuclear Armageddon.
It was treated very, very seriously. It was the atmosphere, I think, as much as anything. It became quite realistic. When...
Is this a game or is it real?
What's the difference?
War Games. Begin playing June 3rd at a theater near you.
It almost triggered the real thing. Now, for the first time on television, the secret crisis of this year is reconstructed, revealing just how close we came to the Third World War.
And Russia, the Bible says, is going to invade.
We were ready for the Third World War, if the Americans started it.
We may have been at the brink of nuclear war and not even known it.
It was normal routine work. Time was passing by. At around 10 p.m., we were finished with our tea and food. Time was approaching when the spacecraft came into orbit. All was going well. We were prepared just in case. And this just in case happened.
It was a literal time that this was going to happen.
There was a big overhead display with huge letters, like a wall banner at my eye level. Start. The siren howled. The report started coming in about the launching of a ballistic rocket from the United States of America.
But there could be some big boom boom all around going on when this thing starts.
Another alarm came on. The system showed another rocket, then a third, fourth, fifth, all within 5 minutes. So there is a rocket attack sign on the overhead displays now. I started giving commands, everyone in place, monitor all functions, do this and that, according to instructions. Everything pointed to a yes except for one thing. The launch was not confirmed visually. 30 levels of defense. To get through them was serious.
We have a Soviet launch.
What the hell?
Missile warning, no malfunction.
I had to make a decision. I decided this was a false alarm. I decided, in the end, that it would be less damaging to qualify the rockets we detected as false alarms. After 10 or 11 minutes passed, the relief came. The over-the-horizon radio location radar stations did not find anything. And the decision I had made was confirmed. The start was false.
It means that you are safe from attack or fallout for the time being, and that you can go out again. But keep listening for further warnings, or to your radio for further advice. Thank you.